My husband and I, Mr. Romanus Asongani, after several years of marriage, have decided by God's grace to come to the altar for nuptial benediction. Really, we have been together for several years, and with all the numerous blessings we have obtained from God Almighty, we thought it wise to come before Him and say, thank you, Jesus.
We are blessing our church wedding 18 years after we did our traditional wedding. And many people will be asking this question, why up to 18 years? I think what I can tell people is that God's time is the best. And this is the time that God has answered. And this is the time to answer that call. Church marriage is not a child place. It's something you have to think, and we have thought and taken that decision, that step now, to move ahead for the blessing of this union that has been existing for the past 18 years.
Choosing Mr. Romanus Asongani as a husband was God's will, because I believe it's God who gave him to me. I cannot really say how it all began, but we found ourselves together. I did not choose him only because he's just a man like any other person. He is completely a different man. A very straightforward somebody, leadership qualities, and most of all, so respectful. Both of us come from very humble families, with the characters I saw from my own parents who never quarreled before children. We tried to copy those characters and move ahead in our own life.
Many people who know Romanus will be asking question that how did you, Romanus, get to know my beautiful wife, Madame Margaret? I think it is God's blessing, and it is the will of God. And I will give special thanks also to a good number of my friends who guided, whom the Lord sent them to lead me. And since that I knew her, as if God was a plan for God, that she was waiting for me and I was waiting for her.
This couple have actually lived together for years and have experienced the number of years with which they have lived together. Some years ago when I joined them, I can gladly say that I was so overwhelmed to be chosen to go be with them in Yaoundé. And for all these years I have grown with them. For the past 16 years, I can tell you that I have learned totally a lot of things. So many things from this couple. They have been to me like a true example of a couple.
Maggie is my bestie. I've known her for so many years. We've been together many years, decades already. So I've known her, I've admired her. She's a wonderful person. I've learned how to keep a home from her. We've both exchanged being together, not in a negative point of view, but from the positive side of it. We know in marriage we all have up and downs, but with this particular case, I would say she's perfect. They are perfect couples.
I have witnessed so much or learned so much how a couple should live, because there have been no day I have stood before them and have been like, maybe this union would not have ever taken place. They've given so much insight. They've called me several times to caution me on how to live, and I stand today as the elder sister of the children, to the kids.
We have been living together happily. Each time we spend our life together, and God blesses us with children and blesses us with unity, that we have always been pulling along together without problems. Though marriage is not a bed of roses, both of us have gone through a lot of challenges, but that notwithstanding, we still try to overcome them.
The difficulties that we have had, that don't call it difficulties, because as a Christian, as we are, we have learned to live the cross. any difficulties that we have, any encounter that we have that is a little bit troubling, we entrust it to our Lord Jesus Christ, who died on the cross for us. The idea that we have in mind concerning the life of Madame Kera Lubick, we are used to the idea of carrying our cross. So any difficulties that we have, that I have, I think I try to put into practice that spirit of carrying our cross and put into practice in it. So I can't really say that there are any difficulties, because to me it has become as a daily routine, as a routine that we carry our cross ourselves, and as the gospel was seen a few days ago, that we should be ready to carry our cross. We have had a lot of difficulties, but those difficulties make us to be stronger.
I've not really been so strong in marriage, because I can say nobody knows everything. But from my own little experience, for the number of years we have been together, I copied the experience from my parents, who did not argue in front of children, who did not fight in front of children, though there is always a small war in every marital home. But my husband and I have never done any of such in front of the children. Whatever might be boiling in us, we make sure the children go to sleep, we iron it out, or we get to our matrimonial room and sort the problems out. We also make sure we don't sleep over a problem. When the cool down period is over, we try to sort it out so that I don't get up the next morning with anger or not smiling with one another, as is always smiling.
Going to her union with Mr. Roman, I have seen her as that person who is not just a wife, she's a virtuous woman. She is that woman who will keep her home intact, her children intact, and everything. And what I have also learned is that marriage is not just about being together, but it's about finding a soulmate, because they think together, they reason together. In short, everything about them is together. They do it in the absence of another person, the other one does it so perfectly well. You will not notice when Mr. Romanus is not around. You will not notice when Madame Maggie is not around. They are always doing things as if they were together.
Couples have the tendency of always portraying what happened behind before kids, but I have never been opportunity to see such an expression. I have been counseled several times, I have been brought up several times as the first child, and I have been made to know that life is not as easy as we think. It is true they have gone through ups and downs, but then I can tell you that all these years of their togetherness, and if it happens today that they are coming together as a union, it simply means that they have exercised lots and lots of patience. It is not easy to see a couple being married for 18 years, and it's today they are blessing their marriage. They have given us a true meaning of patience, which happens to be a virtue. That is which we are carrying as our goal upon this wedding.
As we got married, the date that we are celebrating our church wedding, we have four children, three girls and a boy. And my wish and our prayer is that the will of God should be done for these children, so that they should live and practice the gospel. I don't want to say that they should copy our life. We are not the best, but all what I wish is that they should be able to live and put into practice the gospel. And that is our teaching for these children. And that is what we are trying to incorporate to these children. And I urge each and every one of us that we should try to lead our children, because we are not the best. Our children might go wayward, but we have to encourage them to be able to live the gospel. If we live the gospel, put into practice, it will be the best.
Shortcomings, we all have errors. Like I said earlier, there is no perfection, but she tries to make everything perfect in her home. I remember back in the years, that was I think in 2010, 2011, Mr. Romanus was not here with her in Yaoundé. He was right in Maroua. Myself, I was there in Maroua. She had to leave everything behind to check on him each time he is there. I was so happy with that, because being a mother back here in Yaoundé is not, first of all, easy. A mother, you have to make sure that the children are going to school. You have to drop and pick them. You have to make sure that everything is going rightly. Then your husband is not beside you to give you the courage. And you still, with the babies that were around, she has to leave them, go down up there, check. And she has been a wonderful wife. Whether Mr. Romanus is here or not, she does everything as if she was the contractor.
We come for here for prepare. My pikin marry we the one marry for church. Because nothing we no be even know. For alone be for many years. When my pikin be lost for church. Now it won't come back again. May I be very happy. Then at the thank God, say may God be for front. The beg God say, all people where they there for outside, where did they come? May they work out fine. May God protect them. Save journey to them.
You've been patiently waiting to be celebrated in church, even though you've done the court marriage since, you've done your tradition since, but patiently waiting for the right time to do it in church is a plus, because some women will go mad and say, no, you have been waiting for so long, but you have been patient, and that is what makes it.
The good heart still kept them true up till this moment, where they are not just celebrating their union, but celebrating their children, celebrating everybody's life, and celebrating their success, because that is what this wedding is all about. It has brought a lot of success, a lot of achievement, and I can say that this is one of the greatest achievements that they have gotten so far.
And I pray you continue to commit your union into the hands of God. Let the Almighty continue to direct you the way He has been doing up to this moment. The angels of heaven will always stand for you, protect, guide you, and continue to bless your union with Mr. Roman.
I'll have a little message to pass to my husband, Mr. Romanus Asongani, just to tell him that I greatly acknowledge his efforts towards our well-being with the children, most especially in my academics. It's not all men who accept that their wives should go to school, but when I told him after some years that I would like to go back to school, he accepted. Not only did he accept, but he also supported me fully in academic needs. I greatly acknowledge him for standing by my side always in times of difficulty, providing me with solutions, and the fact that we always pray together when we find no solution. We ask for it from God.
I did thank God plenty. May God give them long life, and may He give me too long life for hold up the kingdom, for see that the kingdom, great and great, great children. May God give the glory and see them.
Thank you so much, Maggie, for being there. I appreciate the fact that you have chosen me your mate matron. It is not given to everybody. You have so many friends around you, so many friends we interact with together, but you choose me. It means you've given me a lot of trust and confidence for the time being. It's not a relationship of just a few years behind we have been into. It's a long-term relationship. I will say thank you for the big privilege you've given me to be with you this time.
Pour à Monsieur Romanus et Madame Marguerite que ce n'est pas la fin. Mais pour aujourd'hui, j'ai cette opportunité pour vous dire que félicitations et bonne chance.
I would like to thank all those who have supported us, who have been praying for us, who have been praying that this day should come and pass. I will not end up without thanking some few persons, and particularly Père Victor Méli, qui est à l'Ouest, qui nous a accompagnés de début jusqu'à ce jour. Je prie aussi et je remercie aussi nos parents, Monsieur et Madame Luxipo, nous ont accompagnés, qu'ils ont accepté de nous accompagner. Parce que pour être un parent, il ne suffit pas de venir signer que vous êtes des parents, mais d'accompagner les couples. Et comme ils ont accepté de faire ce travail, je prie Dieu que va nous donner l'esprit, la sagesse pour nous aider aussi à accomplir la volonté de Dieu. Et finalement, je remercie aussi tous les membres du mouvement de Fokoyari, toutes nos réunions, membres de nos réunions qui ont venu nous soutenir. Que la seule chose que je peux vous dire, c'est qu'il faut continuer à aimer.
I would like to greatly acknowledge the presence of everyone here. On behalf of my husband and I, we want to appreciate your effort, your sacrifices for abandoning your activities, spending a lot of money, and taking the risks to join us here today. Thank God for our lives. For all those present here today, I would really like to employ the intercession of Jesus to be with us as we celebrate the day and throughout the day. Thank you all once more for coming. Thank you all once more for accepting our invitations. Thank you all for being here present.
I've heard there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do you? Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah.